ओके जी, सो इन फर्स्ट टू फोर्ट्स वी हैव कवर्ड द डिफरेंट मेथड्स, द डायरेक्ट मेथड्स एंड इनडायरेक्ट मेथड्स फॉर द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द क्रॉप वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट एट अ स्पेसिफिक एरिया एट अ गिवन कंडीशंस. ओके, नाउ इन थर्ड फोर्ट ऑफ दिस लेक्चर हियर वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंट इरीगेशन इफिशियंसीज. ओके, सो सी efficient use of water is an obligation of each user as well as of the planners. Okay, even under the best method of irrigation, not all the water supplied during an irrigation is stored in the root zone. Yeah, all the water which is supplied in the irrigation is not properly or completely utilized by the crops. Okay, so in general, efficiency is the ratio of the water output at a point to the water input at a point. Okay, mean the water output at a specific point divided by the water input into that systems. Okay, and the objective of the efficiency concept is to show when improvements can be made which will result in more efficient irrigation. Okay, remember basically there are two purposes of to account the irrigation efficiencies in the we can say that in different irrigation projects. First one is that to make the more efficient irrigation system, yeah, to reduce the losses. Okay, if you know that, suppose if there is more difference between the output and the input values, so it means that more amount of water is being we can say that losing in the system. So to reduce that losses, the system, yeah, the methods will become more efficient. One is that requirement. Second and most importantly, for example, here you have the different crops. Okay, so the methods which we have discussed for the determination of the consumptive use, that is actually the crop water requirement. Okay, it means that this much water will be properly utilized by the crops. Okay, mean this is the power demand, this is the power requirement of a specific crop at a given area under the given climatic condition. Okay, now see, for example, the crop will need to extract this much water from the root zone. Okay, so how much water you will have to store in the root zone, yeah, we can say that how much water is available in the root zone. Okay, so the from the available water, how much water is the crop actually utilizing. Okay, so that will be called, see, the water utilized by the crops beneficially divided by the water which was available. Okay, so that is the output, that is the input, so that will be a term of the water use efficiency. Okay, similarly, how much water is being stored here and how much water has been applied. Okay, so that will be, we can say that see, some amount of water will be deep percolated, mean the water which you are applying into the earth surface, that will be not 100% stored in the root zone. So how much is stored in the root zone, how much is deep percolated, so that will be considered as a water storage efficiency. Okay, similarly, suppose that is the field, so if you are delivering some amount of water into the field, so some amount of water will be lost from the field due to the we can say that due to the runoff, yeah, some water will be directly evaporated during the application. So the amount of water which you are applying and the amount of water which is storing into the root zone, that will be also termed as the water application efficiency. Okay, and second one and the most importantly, suppose here you have the reservoir or the river from where you are diverting the water into the canal systems, so see how much water you are diverting here and how much water is available here. So that will be a term of output and that will be a term of input. So the ratio between these two is called the water conveyance efficiency. Now see, how much water is properly required by the plant. Yeah, what is the power demand of the plant? What is the power, we can say that utilization of the plant? So here, when you account the water usage efficiency, when you account the water storage efficiency, when you account the water application efficiency, when you account the water conveyance efficiency, so here then you will get the irrigation requirement. Okay, and that is the most important parameters in any design, planning and management management of irrigation structures. Okay, so here we will discuss these different types of efficiencies, like the water conveyance efficiency, application efficiency, okay, the water use efficiency, water storage efficiency, water distribution efficiency, consumptive use efficiency, and uniformity coefficient. See, these two are the other parameters which are just indicating that either the water is uniformly distributed throughout the field or not. Yeah, suppose some portion of the field is over irrigated or some portion of the field is under irrigated. Okay, so see, water conveyance efficiency, it is defined as the ratio of the water delivered to a pump or field to the quantity of water diverted from a source. See, either you will have a reservoir, either you will have a running stream or river from where you will have to divert the water into the canal system, okay, which will convey the water into the specific area which you have to irrigate, okay, to the field. So now see, the water which is delivered into the field, the water which is available at the head of the field, divided by the water which you have diverted from the reservoir or from the canal, yeah, the water which is available at the head of the canal. So the ratio of these two discharges, or the ratio of these two volumes, or the ratio of these two amount of water is called the water conveyance efficiency. Okay, so water conveyance efficiency, yeah, that is also called the transmission losses. Okay, and that is just the ratio between the water applied into the field divided by the water applied into the conveyance system. Clear? Second, we have the water application efficiency. Okay, so the ratio of the quantity of water stored in the root zone of the crop to the quantity of water diverted into the field. See, now the water which is available at the head of the field, yeah, the water which is outing from a conveyance system, that will be input for the field. Okay, now how much water you have diverted or delivered into the field, and out of that water which is delivered into the field, how much is stored in the root zone. So the water which is stored in the root zone divided by the water which is delivered into the field, that is called the water application efficiency. Okay, so this focuses the attention of the suitability of the method of application, that how much water you are delivering into the field and how much from that delivered water is stored in the root zone. So it is mostly depend on the method of application of the water into the crops. For example, the surface method, the sprinkler method, or the trickle method. Okay, so as compared to sprinkler or trickle method, more amount of water is stored in the root zone in the trickle method, because in the surface method the evapotranspiration losses are more, the runoff losses are more, so less amount of water is stored in the root zone. Okay, so see, the common sources of the water during the application is the runoff. Okay, means suppose the water which you have applied into the field, so most portion of the water will be run out from the field. Okay, and secondly, some portion of the water will be deep percolated. Deep percolated means the movement of the water beyond the root zone depth. Okay, mean we are interested into some specific depth. Yeah, the root can extract the water from some specific depth, but if the water goes beyond the root zone, then it will be a type of loss. Okay, so the water which you have delivered into the field, either some portion of it will be stored in the root zone, some portion of the water will be run out from the field, and some portion will be deep percolated. So the water which is stored in the root zone divided by the water which is applied into the field, that will be the application efficiency. Okay, yeah, we can say that the water storage will be equal to the water applied into the field minus run up and minus deep percolation. Okay, so in a well-designed surface irrigation system, the water application efficiency can be 60%, but averagely the surface application is the application efficiency of the surface system is almost 30 to 40%. Okay, in the sprinkler irrigation, this efficiency is about 75%. Okay, so the common factor for the losses Here is the irregular land surface or the shallow soil surface. Okay, you are very small or excessively large irrigation streams are applied at a time. Okay, no attendance is applied, mean no labors are available at a time of application, or water is applied for a long time. Okay, wrong irrigation method is selected for the given area. Okay, improper preparation of land mean the land is not properly prepared. Okay, yeah, the land is more the soil is more impervious. Okay, yeah, there is steep slopes. So these are the different causes through which the application efficiency are reduced. Okay, next one is the water use efficiency. So it is defined as the ratio of the water beneficially used to water delivered to the field, including the leaching requirement. Now remember, sometime salt particles are deposited in the root zone. Okay, so to wash out that salt particle, some extra water are applied in the irrigation. Okay, see, we have the crop water requirement, so the irrigation which you are applying, that will be according to the crop water requirement. But for example, if there is salt particle is present, then for the washing out of that salt particle or draining out that salt particle from the root zone, we are applying some extra water in the irrigation. Okay, so that is called the leaching requirement. Okay, so the water which you have delivered into the field, okay, that will be the total water. Okay, mean the either the water for the beneficial uses or the water for the leaching. So the total water which is delivered into the field and the water which is beneficially used, mean how much water is actually extracted by the plants, that will be the beneficial use. So the beneficial use divided by the water which is delivered, that is called the water use efficiency. Okay, next one we have the water storage efficiency. Remember the difference between the application efficiency and the storage efficiency. Okay, so the application efficiency is the water just stored in the root zone. Okay, the water just stored in the root zone divided by the total applied water. For example, if you have applied the 10 liter of water, and out of 10 liter, for example, 8 liter has been stored in the root zone. Okay, so it means that suppose 2 liter has been lost in the runoff, or that is lost in the deep percolation, and 8 liter is stored in the root zone. So the application efficiency will be, we can say that 80%. Okay, that is the application efficiency, remember. And the water storage efficiency, that is the ratio between the water stored in the root zone during irrigation to the water needed in the root zone, mean what was the demand. Yeah, we can say that what was the irrigation depth required and how much depth has been applied, how much depth has been stored in the root zone, that will be termed as the water storage efficiency. Okay, or simply we can say that, for example, the field capacity of the soil is, for example, the field capacity of the soil is 30%. Okay, and suppose the lower limit of the readily available water, yeah, the maximum allowable deficiency is, for example, 15%. Okay, so see how much irrigation is required, yeah, how much water is needed in the root zone. So actually in the irrigation we are raising the moisture content from the lower limit of readily available water to the field capacity level. Okay, so see the demand of the irrigation is the field capacity minus the lower limit of the readily available water. So how much percentage of water is needed? 15%. Okay, we have to raise the moisture content level from 15% to 30%. Now see, when you apply the water, so how much was actually stored in the root zone? For example, the moisture content was raised up to 28%. So we can say that actually the moisture content was raised from 15 to 28%, and the requirement, the need was from 15 to 30%. So how much was applied? 28 minus 15, that is 13. So the water which is actually stored in the root zone divided by the water which was demanded, yeah, which was needed, so that will be called the water storage efficiency. Okay, so the concept of water storage is just how completely the required water has been stored. Okay, mean see, the requirement was 15% and storage occurred 13%. Okay, so the ratio between these two is the we can say that that is the storage efficiency. Clear? Okay. The water distribution efficiency. Okay, so it evaluates the degree to which water is uniformly distributed throughout the root zone or not. Okay, the more uniformly the water is distributed, the better will be the crop response. Okay, see if that is the given field. So see, at throughout the field the water is supposed uniformly distributed, then the crop response, the yield will be uniform throughout the area, throughout the field. Okay, yeah, we can say that water distribution efficiency is just showing us that which area of the field received more water, yeah, which area of the field is over irrigated and which area is under irrigated. Okay, water distribution efficiency just evaluates the degree to which water is uniformly distributed throughout the root zone. Okay, uneven distribution has many undesirable results. For example, the crop yield will be affected, the crop yield will be not uniform. Okay, so the more uniformly the water is distributed, the better will be the crop responses. Okay, so see, that is 101 minus y divided by d. So y is the average numerical deviation and depth of water stored from average depth stored during the irrigation. See, d is the average depth. Okay, the average depth of the water stored in the root zone. So see, for example, just take 5 points or place different stakes at different points. Okay, for example, at this stake you have measured that the water received at this point is 6 centimeter, here it is 5 centimeter, for example here is 4 centimeter, here is 3 centimeter, for example here is 4 centimeter, here is 5 centimeter. Okay, so at different points of the field, for example, you have measured that this point, these points have received this much amount of water. Okay, so what is the average depth received? That will be d. Okay, see, 5 or 6, that is 11, 15, 18, 22, 27. 27 divided by 6, so you will get 4.5. So for example, that is the average depth of water stored in the irrigation. Okay, now see, what is the deviation of this value from the mean value? Okay, so the deviation of this value from the mean value is 1.5. okay, 1.5. so that is the, we can say that that is the deviation of this point. Similarly, what is the deviation of this point? So that is we can say that 0.5. okay, what is the deviation of this point? Again, that is, we can say that that is 0.5. okay, the deviation of this point, that is 1.5. I mean, each and every point is deviated from the average value, and if the all the points get zero deviation from the average value, so we will say that the water is 100% uniformly applied. Okay, and that will be an ideal case. Clear? So these are the deviation. Now, average numerical deviation and depth of water. Now, what is the average deviation? Mean, take the average of these values, so that will be y. So it will give you the distribution efficiency. Okay, and this efficiency provides a measure for comparing various system or methods of water application. Okay, for example, the sprinkler compared to the mean, there are different types of the sprinkler system, so it will be compared with each other. Mean, suppose in the sprinkler irrigation system, again, we have different systems, we have different types of system, the pivoted system, the centrifuge system, okay, the pop-up sprinklers. So among them, we can compare the distribution efficiency, that which system is more efficient in term of uniformity. Okay, consumptive use efficiency, that is actually the water which is consumed by the normal consumption use of water, and the net amount of water depleted from the root zone. See, for example, that is the crops. Okay, so see, suppose that is the field capacity. Okay, and that is the lower limit of the readily available water. Yeah, we can say that the maximum allowable depletion. Okay, in the limit up to which you are allowing to deplete the moisture content, yeah, the limit up to which you are allowing to to decrease the availability of the moisture content. That is the maximum available deficiency. Okay, so how much water has been depleted? For example, the feed capacity is 30%. Okay, and you are allowing the deficiency, for example, up to 15%. Okay, so see, when the moisture content is reduced from 30 to 15%, it means that 15% of water has been depleted from the root zone. Okay, but how much is actually utilized by the crops? Suppose the crops has actually utilized 14%. Okay, so 14%, that is the water which is actually utilized, yeah, normally utilized by the plants, and divided by the water which is actually depleted. So that is called the consumptive use efficiency. Okay, and the efficiency therefore evaluate the loss of water by deep percolation, mean again some amount of water has been deep percolated from the root zone. Okay, see, one is the deep percolation during the application of water, and one is the deep percolation suppose if you are not applying the water, not during the application of water, but still there is some deep percolation is occurring from the root zone. Okay, so that will be considered as a type of the losses during the uses. Okay, during the usage, so that will be the water which is actually utilized by the plants and the water which is depleted from the root zone. Okay, the uniformity coefficient, again that is a little bit similar to the water distribution efficiency. Okay, again it gives us the indication that how much water is uniformly irrigated, how much uniformly applied. Okay, this measure the uniformity of irrigation. Okay, so see again the problem which we have discussed, for example that is the field. Okay, so take different points, suppose 6 points you have taken out, so just take different stakes and find out the depth of the application of water. Okay, so how much depth is applied here at different points. Okay, so take the average value of that applied water. Okay, so M is that mean depth of the water. Okay, yeah, the water which is unfiltered, mean that will be infiltrated. Okay, and see how much is the observation. So you can see here, suppose that is the 6 is observation, how much so the when the number of observation is more, then the more uniformity will be assessed. Okay, and see how much is the average deviation of this depth from the mean depth, the deviation of this depth from the mean depth, the deviation from the, so determine the deviation of each depth from the mean value and take the absolute summation, mean don't consider the negative and positive, just take the difference and sum of all their differences. Okay, divide by the mean value and the number of observations, so you will get the uniformity coefficient, and it is also called the Christiansen uniformity coefficient. Again, it indicates that how much the water is uniformly applied. Okay, so see at the start of this lecture, we have just discussed an example of the water extraction from the ground reservoirs, and we have just discussed the efficiencies of the pump and the motors, that what is the what is the actual power required for the raising of water from one point to another point, and when we account the efficiency of the pump and efficiency of the motor, so we get the power which is required, when we get the electrical power. Okay, so similarly in the first part and second part we have discussed the different methods for the determination of the consumptive use. Okay, so that is the power demand, that is the power requirement of the crops, and here we have discussed different efficiencies. So now when that efficiencies are accounted into the actual crop water requirement, so we will get the irrigation requirement, that how much water you have to divert from a resource, how much water you have to divert from a reservoir. Okay, so that is the key requirement of the irrigation engineering. So see here, as we have already discussed, consumptive use or evapotranspiration, the depth of water consumed by the evaporation and transpiration during the crop growth, including water consumed by the accompanying weed. Okay, mean the total water which is actually utilized by the crop. So see, these terms will be determined by the direct and indirect methods which we have discussed. Okay, then also we have to know about the effective rainfall. Okay, mean the precipitation falling during the growing period of a crop that is available to meet the evapotranspiration. Mean how much water has been contributed from the rainfall and to the crop consumption. Okay, so that is called the effective rainfall. It does not include the precipitation lost through deep percolation below the root zone or the water loss as the surface runoff. Mean see when a rainfall is occurred in an area, so some amount of rainfall is run out from the area, some is deep percolated. So the amount of water which contribute to the consumptive use, yeah, the water which is utilized by the plant in evaporation and transpiration, that will be actually subtracted from the total consumptive use. So you will get the irrigation requirement, that how much water you have to artificially supply. For example, if a crop have total demand of 15 centimeter throughout its season, okay, mean in whole season, for example, a crop is utilizing 50 centimeter of water. Now see, suppose in that season, for example, 10 centimeter of water is contributed from the rainfall. So what will be the water which you have to artificially supply? That is 40 centimeter. So this 40 centimeter is called the consumptive irrigation requirement. Okay, it is the amount of irrigation water required in order to meet the evapotranspiration need of the crop during its full growth. It is therefore nothing but the consumptive itself, but exclusive of the effective precipitation. So see, consumptive irrigation requirement will be equal to the total demand divided by the water which is contributed from the rainfall. Okay, so this much water you have to, yeah, this much water will be utilized by the plant, and that will be this amount of water will be provided by some artificial method. Okay, now see the net irrigation requirement. So it is the amount of irrigation water required in order to meet the evapotranspiration need of the crop as well as the other needs. For example, now that is the power requirement of the crop. See, that was the total requirement, this much is contributed from the rainfall, so this much amount of water you have to supply. Now if suppose there is some salt particle and you have to wash out, drain out that from the root zone, so you will have to apply some more water, some additional water out of this one. Okay, mean some extra, some additional water will be accompanied with this amount to fulfill the also the leaching requirement. So then it is called the net irrigation requirement. Okay, so in some areas, for example, there is no salt particle or no leaching is required, then in that case the net irrigation requirement will be equal to the consumptive irrigation requirement. Okay, then we have the feed irrigation requirement. See, some amount of water will be lost in the runout and some amount will be in deep percolation. Okay, now see, to the crops you will have to apply this much water, but if you account that runout losses and the deep percolation losses, then it will be called the feed irrigation requirement. It means that this much amount of water you have to apply without the losses, without the runout losses or the deep percolation losses. But if you are going to account it, then it means that the net irrigation requirement divided by the application efficiency. Okay, how much water you are applying into the field divided by how much water is stored in the root zone for the utilization, that will be actually the NIR. So NIR divided by the we can say that divided by the applied water, that is the application efficiency. So you see, the water which is required for the utilization divided by the application efficiency, this much water you have to apply at this point, that is the field irrigation requirement. Okay, yeah, this much amount of water will be available at the head of the field. Okay, so it is the amount of water required to meet the net irrigation plus the water loss in percolation in the field. Then at the end, see, this much amount of water will be required at the head of the field. Now suppose here is the source of the water from which you have to convey the water into the field. Okay, so how much will be diverted here through reservoir, through barrages or through weir, yeah, how much water will you will have to supply from a reservoir. Okay, so see, there will be some losses in the conveyance system. Again, that losses will be the evaporation losses, seepage losses, or other losses. Okay, that will be discussed in detail in the canal chapters. So see, when that conveyance efficiency is accounted into the water which is required at the head of the field, then you will get the gross irrigation requirement. Okay, so that is equal to the field irrigation requirement divided by the conveyance efficiency, the system conveyance efficiency. Okay, so these are the definite efficiencies which are when accounted into the actual water requirement, then you get the gross irrigation requirement. It means that this much amount of water will be diverted from a reservoir or from a river or canal. Okay, so this much water will be available at the field, okay, and this much water will be available for the we can say that for the crop utilization. Clear? Okay, now we have the assessment of the irrigation water. Okay, assessment of the irrigation water. So the water which has been supplied for irrigation to the farmers, is it the, we can say that, is it the government expenses? Okay, I mean government or constructing different conveyance structure, different reservoirs, different storages, so they're expanding on it. Okay, so some nominal charges must therefore be levied on the farmers for using this water. Okay, so when, for example, if you are utilizing the if you are consuming the electricity, okay, so if we are consuming the electricity, so we are paying for it. Okay, we are paying the electricity bills for it. Clear? So similarly, if the farmer is utilizing the irrigation water, okay, the so they will have to pay for it. Clear? The fixation of such charges is known as assessment of the irrigation water. Okay, mean the charges which the farmers are paying in response of the utilization of the irrigation water, that is called the assessment. Yeah, that is called just the irrigation charges. The returns on the capital investment is based upon the estimate of such water charges. Okay, mean how much water a farmer is utilizing. Clear? So how much will have to pay. Clear? So these are the different reasons that why the government are charging the farmers. So to recover the cost of construction of the water project, for example, the reservoir, the barrages which the government is constructing, or the conveyance system, the irrigation canals, yeah, the canals which they are lining, okay, yeah, the land which they are preparing for the farmers, so that cost of construction will be recovered on some subsidy basis. Okay, also to recover the maintenance cost of the various works and the stops. Okay, mean the stop which are working in the irrigation department, or some other maintenance cost of the irrigation projects which is required, or the irrigation structures is required, so that will be also we can say that recovered. To collect some revenue for the nation, okay, that is also one of the requirement. And the most importantly, to check the cultivators against uneconomical and careless use of the water. For example, if you are not charging the farmers, okay, if you are not taking the bills in response of the irrigation water, then the farmer will be utilizing the water carelessly. Okay, they will be wasting the water, and as we have already discussed, that the water is a scarce natural resource. Okay, so then the wastage will be occur. So that is the most important parameter that the governments must have to charge the farmers. Okay, and we have the different methods. For example, first is the assessment of the area basis or the crop rate basis. Okay, so under this system of assessment of irrigation, area which is sown by the crops is recorded. Okay, by the different we can say by this different stop of the irrigation department. So as much as the area is more, then the farmer will have to more money. Okay, mean the charges will be more. Okay, and similarly, second method is the volumetric method. But remember, in this method, the farmers can be utilizing the water carelessly or uneconomically, because they are only paying on the area basis. Okay, but this method, the volumetric assessment, that is the best one. Okay, which is charging the farmer on the basis of the amount of water, that how much water they are utilizing. Okay, so that will be just on discharge basis, on volume basis. Okay, the method involves the living charges on actual volume of water supplied to a specific area. Okay, this will be an ideal system under which the irrigator has an incentive for economic use of water, and shortfalls in supply can be distinctly located. Okay, it is however not a very practical method, but this method must be adopted to reduce the much losses of the irrigation water. Okay, third method of the assessment is on the seasonal basis. Okay, see, in this method the farmers are charged on the basis of the season. For example, in 1 year there are two seasons, so in one season the crop demand will be more, so the crop utilization will be more. In another season the crop demand will be less, so the utilization will be less. Okay, so so it will be based on that utilization, on that demand there. For example, in one season if the demand is more, so then the assessment charges will be also more. Okay, so that is based on the seasonal basis. Okay, there are also different other methods, but these three are the most commonly used methods. Okay, so this was all about the lecture number 5, in which we have just discussed the basic terminologies, and then we have discussed the direct methods for the determination of consumptive use, then we have discussed the indirect methods, okay, and then we have discussed different efficiencies, and then based on that efficiencies are accounted and to the actual crop water requirement, and we have determined the irrigation requirement, feed irrigation requirement and gross irrigation requirement. Okay, and then we have discussed some of the assessment or some charges of the irrigation water. Clear? So this was all about the chapter number 2, and inshallah in next lectures we will start our new chapter, which is about the canal, okay, the conveyance system of the irrigation. Clear? Thank you.